Perfect.
What is up, y'all? And today, you read from the title, but I'm gonna be going under the truck and I'm gonna be giving it an undercoat. You can see my rear axle, it's kind of dirty and a little bit rusty, so I'm gonna try and get some stuff to get the rust off or kind of fight the rust, and then we go back and we get that rubberized. I don't know exactly what I'm gonna get yet, but I'm trying to get like some rubberized stuff and maybe not rubber, but I don't know, some kind of coating to spray on there to try and fight all that crap. Before I do anything, I'm going to go in and I'm going to pressure wash it the best I can. Because a lot of that's just dirt, like you can see right there, where I got most of it off. But a lot of that's just dirt, so I might just try and pressure wash some of it. And then, if I really have to, then I'll spray something on there, try and get that off. But I mean, I think I'll just go on there with the pressure washer and hit it really good. That should be fine. That's the only really part I'm worried about right there, but I mean, that's honestly not even that bad. So, yeah.
I'm gonna go and try and get into Lowe's and get what I need. Get out without getting the Rona or dying. So,
dear God, there's so many people here.
Look, they even have a CDC surveillance camera thing. Quiet, focus. Yeah, you can't even read the sign. That says, surveillance, security. Cameras on top.
But, wish me luck.
So, I went to Lowe's, I got the Rust-Oleum undercarriage spray. I went with the pro grade instead of the regular grade, just because I want a little bit better finish. And, they was both the same price, so I thought, why the heck not. So, about to give the truck a little bath here. So, as you can tell, she's a tad bit dirty, and the wheels aren't that bad, but, it needs some attention. And, it's just a little bit of dirt. Nothing much, nothing major, but figured since I'm gonna pressure wash the undercarriage, might as well let you do the whole thing. So I'm gonna go do the whole two bucket method, wipe her down, and then I'm gonna probably spend maybe 2 hours on this undercarriage. Cause I mean, it's not too terrible, but there are some parts that need good attention, like up here, that need some good attention. But this will be fun. Something different, something I haven't done. But here we go. So, foam of choice today is no other than Citrus Washing Gloss by Chemical Guys. Love this thing, probably my favorite foam they make. I think last time I tried that VO7, and it worked out all right, but kind of wasn't my favorite. I just like the way this like makes paint feel slick, and then it works really great with the wax. Makes it really slick, so when it rains, everything beads perfectly, and it really makes my paint pop, and that's probably my favorite part about it. So, here we go.
I like to do a walk around, kind of before I detail, just so you can kind of see how dirty the truck really, truly is. Let's see all the dust, crap right there, and you can really hear it. Just, I don't know, I just like showing what Chemical Guys can really do and why I trust this product so much. You can see there's like a bunch of, I mean, it's really just light stuff, it's nothing major. So, I mean, you'll be able to tell some slight differences, but I'm gonna try and foam under the entire truck too, because I normally have a little bit left after I do the whole truck. So I'm gonna do the whole truck, the whole body first, then I'm gonna focus on the undercarriage second.
Perfect.
So as you can tell, just for the first wash, for the Citrus Washing Gloss, the reds are already popping a lot better than what it was. And I mean, I didn't get all the foam because I'm about to go back and foam it again. So I'm gonna go around the whole truck, foam it again, then I'm gonna go wipe, and y'all know the process. Y'all seen it twice already, but yeah, it's just the first wash. Thank you. So I just went, cleaned the whole truck, and then I dried it off with big old towel. I forget what the actual name of it is. But before I clean my wheels, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna do the undercarriage first, because I mean, I'm gonna be pressure washing the whole thing, so they're gonna get wet. So I don't wanna have to clean them and then re-clean them, you know? So I'm gonna go ahead and start pressure washing the undercarriage. I'll film a little bit of it, but I'm probably gonna be doing this step for a while. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and start pressure washing what I can. I gotta let that dry, and then once I do that, then I'll go back over with the Rust-Oleum on the end here. Get all that crap like that out of there. So here we go. You guys a little bit of a before and after here. A little bit closer up what this looks like now. Try and get all of that. And the really big difference is going to be back here. My rear axle. It's going to be the doer right there. This is all the crap, dirt, mud, grease. Like, I had pebbles and rocks up under there. Well, not these kind of rocks. These are from over there. But, like, all these small ones right there, those are from my undercarriage. All this. I haven't even done the rear end yet. I've done parts of it, but I haven't done, like, the rear axle. Get all up under here. It looks so much better. Let's see. And I'm about to get down and dirty up under here. I'm gonna record me hitting the rear axle, but after that I'm gonna have to put the camera up, because I really don't want it to get messed up. But like up under here, then where I took my spare tire out, I'm leaving that in there because I plan on putting a train horn in here eventually one of these days, but for right now it's just gonna sit tight like that. I got everything that I could. Best pressure washer. So what I'm gonna do now is, since I do have a little bit of foam left over, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna hit what I can in my undercarriage with some foam. And I'll get anything that's loose or any crap out of there that's left that I couldn't reach or couldn't get or whatever with the good enough with the pressure washer. Then I'm gonna let this dry, let it sit and dry, and then go back over it with the undercoat and stuff. As you can see, all this is the crap that was under my truck right here. All this nasty junk, black, grease, dirt, mud, rocks, sticks. All of it's just a combination of what's been under this truck from when I've had it and from when the dude had the truck before had it. But this is what I could get best with the pressure washer. But yeah, I'm gonna get back and I'm gonna foam it. Really, I'm foaming it to kind of get what the new McGoy's parts on it from the lift kit. Because I've pretty much done my justice what I could with the pressure washer. And, but yeah, nonetheless, I'm gonna go through, foam it, and then show you guys the final product. So here's the undercarriage foam. If you get any loose dirt and crap, mud, whatever junk is on my undercarriage, you get all that loose stuff off of there. Then I'll go back and I'll pressure wash it, let it sit and dry. And, while it's drying, I'm gonna go ahead and clean my wheels too, because they require water. But yeah. So now that the truck is mint, I'm gonna go back. I'm starting the axle and see how it works. How it works out for me, but I'm gonna start right here, get what I can. And then I'll move up to the side frame, side of the frame up here, and get some of that right there. Thank you. So I just finished the undercoat on the truck. Did a little bit of the front end, you can see right there. I did under here. Did the frame a little bit. It's still drying. But I did the frame. And the main thing I was really concerned about was my rear axle. Just kind of getting all that. And then you know we gotta have the black. You know we gotta have the black exhaust tip right here. I mean, it just goes so well with the truck. But man, I think it looks pretty freaking good. Some spots better than others. It's kind of. Yep. That was the last spot I painted. Was right there. So I mean, it's still settling a little bit in there, but then once it dries, it'll look really good. And don't worry, I'm not. This isn't staying like this. I'm gonna redo my exhaust hopefully next week. But yeah, she looks pretty good. Got it all shined up. Wheels clean, tires clean, truck cleaned. Heck yeah.
But if you have a truck like mine and you don't want to spend a ton of money, this cost under $20 to do. I spent, I think it's like $17 to do all of this right here. I threw it away, but it's the Rust-Oleum Pro Grade undercarriage. It comes in a can, pretty big can. I got two of them that did me in pretty fine, front to back. But I mean, I highly recommend doing it. It does justice. Makes it look a lot better. Makes the truck look a heck of a lot better. But Rust-Oleum Pro Grade undercarriage spray. It's a rubberized. It's like a rubber. Some rubberized coat, some crap like that, but
I'm so glad I did it. Really puts the detail into the truck. But drop down in the comments below what y'all think I should do next to the truck. I already told you I'm doing exhaust and then eventually tint, but after that, what should I do? Like, what y'all want to see on the truck?
Appreciate the view. Thank y'all for watching. Tune in for more truck stuff. I got a bunch of crap I'm finna do this thing. But, like,
I don't know. I just can't wait to do half the things I'm finna do to this. But appreciate the view. Peace.